Welcome to Mastering Solutions. In this general problem, they tell us that a 50 kilogram box hangs from a rope, and we need to find what the tension in the rope is if the box is at rest, and then for part B, if the box has a velocity of 5 meters per second, and then is also speeding up at 5 meters per second squared. Before we get into the two parts, let's draw our free body diagram here. So we have tension holding the box up, so we have T, and then weight coming down. So that's really all that's going on in this situation because the box is just hanging from this rope. So for part A, they tell us that the box is at rest, meaning it's at static equilibrium. It's not moving or accelerating in the y direction at all. So acceleration in the y direction is zero. If we sum the forces in the y direction, we have positive tension minus a negative weight, and it's going to be equal to zero because it's in static equilibrium. Now we'll add weight over, so we have T is equal to weight, and T we can substitute in the mg for weight, it's equal mg, and then we have all the values for this, so T is equal to 50 kilograms for the box, 50 kgs for the mass, and then gravity, of course, is 9.8 meters per second squared. So we have 50 times 9.8 meters per second squared, so we have 490 newtons for the tension if the box is at rest. So now when we go to part B, we need to figure out what the tension in the rope is if it's moving. The thing is we don't really care what the velocity in the y direction is. That has no bearing on this question. All we care about is the acceleration. So this is really just a distraction to confuse you. So for part B, we'll do the same thing. Acceleration in the y direction now is equal to 5 meters per second squared. So if we sum the forces in the y direction again, it's going to be the same thing as right here. So now when we sum the forces in the y direction, we have tension again, which is positive, minus the weight, of course. But in this case, it'll be equal to ma because we have an acceleration now. So let's add weight over again. So T is equal to ma plus the weight, and we can substitute in mg again, so plus mg. Now if we wanted to, you don't have to do this. You could go ahead and plug everything in now and it would be totally correct. But we could factor this out and simplify it a little bit better so it's a little bit more clean. So T is equal to the mass times the acceleration plus the gravity. As I said, this is optional. It'll give you the exact same answer either way. So we have 50 kilograms is the mass, and then the acceleration we said is 5 meters per second squared, plus gravity, which is 9.8 meters per second squared. And we have 50 times 5 plus 9.8. And then just to show you what I'm talking about, we could do 50 times 5 plus 50 times 9.8, and we have the exact same answer, 740. So the tension when it's accelerating is 740 newtons. So here are your two answers. For part A, when it's at rest, we have 490, and when it's accelerating, we have a tension in the rope of 740 newtons.